Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you're a new subscriber, this is Paji Empire Child Sex Selection. We'll be giving you lots of contents in this channel. So you have already subscribed, so click on your notification bell so that anytime I upload any new video, you'll be notified. So today I have for you erectile dysfunction. Erectile dysfunction is another word for it is impotence. And you know that erectile dysfunction is a very crucial problem in the society because as much as it affects sexual intercourse, it can also have a self image disturbance on the person that has that issue. You understand? So I'm gonna define it. I'm gonna give you some basic causes, some examinations, just few examinations. I'm not gonna be talking everything about erectile dysfunction because it's a very voluminous topic. So I'm gonna give you some remedies in order to help yourself. You can also meet me. I'm a sex therapist. I'm gonna be showing my number on the screen so that you can easily reach out to me. So okay, first of all, erectile dysfunction is, in another word, is known as impotence. Yes, is a condition where the penis cannot erect, like it's flagged down, it cannot erect during sexual intercourse. Sometimes it can erect, but at the maybe in between intercourse, when the thing wants to kick off very well, it flags down. You can see that it can be very, very devastating when this thing happens. So when this thing happens, everybody is, in fact, the person, the man becomes so guilty. The woman is so devastated, so stressed out, so angry that this, in fact, you know, so is a very big problem. It's usually caused by physical, emotional problem, hormonal problem, drugs, endocrine problem, you know. So let's talk about physical problems. Could be example of physical problems are narrowing of the penis, the blood vessels of the penis. You know, when there is a narrowing of these blood vessels, erection will also be terminated. So that is a physical problem. Physical problems like a prostate problem, prostate hypertrophy, high blood pressure, high cholesterol levels, endocrine disorder like diabetes. You know, when there is diabetes, it will cause overweight. So it's also part of physical problem that could happen. Then another one is hormonal problem like testosterone, which is part of the hormone that makes up the male reproductive organ. So when there is a hormonal problem, maybe there is no hormonal, there is no testosterone at all, then we may be looking at going in for hormone replacement therapy. So we go into emotional situations, like, you know, Why I call it emotional is that sometimes someone can have erection in the morning, but during sexual intercourse there'll be no erection again. So emotional problems like stress, anxiety, depression, relationship problems, you know, anything that has to do with the emotions, anger can cause erection, as in loss of erection. So basically this erection of a thing usually happens, apart from the normal, all those physical issues, hormonal problems and all that, sometimes, most times, it also occur with age. Like we men over 40 years, it happens in men, is more common in men over 40 years of age. Another thing is lifestyle can cause someone to basically lose erection. Like if you smoke so much, if you drink a lot, you know, so many things on lifestyle. So lifestyles like sedentary lifestyles, which makes you overweight, it can cause erectile problem. Things like eating so much fats, I call it fats in layman's language so that you understand, but it's cholesterol. You understand? When you fry so much, you fry things, everything you fry, you get your egg, you fry, you get your red oil, you fry, you know, all those things can lead to one issue or the other. It can lead to erectile dysfunction. So those are the lifestyles that can change your reproductive organ as a man. And lifestyle like lack of sleep, you know, you don't sleep as you supposed to do, you don't sleep very well, it can cause erectile dysfunction. So you know, there are so many factors, even medication too, drugs. There are some drugs that can cause erectile dysfunction, like diazepam. Some of you out there that know what diazepam is, is a muscle relaxant. It can relax your nerves and all that. You know, when you take this thing so much, it can cause this erectile dysfunction. Then Valium. Valium is diazepam. Then Agdatone, furosemide. These things can cause erectile dysfunction. Although I didn't say if you were prescribed, if your doctor prescribed these medications for you, that you should stop it. You don't have to stop it. You should also inquire from your GP and tell your GP this is the problem you are facing, if you are facing these issues. But if paraventure, this medication, you abuse them, you need to stop, because it can cause erectile dysfunction. Then I'm gonna be going through okay, I've basically mentioned the causes now. So I'm gonna be talking about the treatments and some diagnoses that will be carried out on you by your GP. On examination, your GP will ask you so many questions about your relationship problems, personal problems, you know, to rule out if the reason for your erection. Will also take your GP would your vital signs will be checked, you know. Also you will also be checked for symptoms of frequent urination, You know, if you pee often, symptoms like that can rule out a prostate problem. And so all these things are the things that will be checked out for. And then like these vital signs that will be checked to is to know if you have high blood pressure. Another lab tests will also be done to you to rule out some certain reasons why you are having this, as in the reasons why you have erectile dysfunction, and to know the basic treatment to give to you. So let's now go to the treatments and lifestyle. So guys, I think I'm gonna end this video here. In my next video, I'll be talking about the treatments to you know, it's a very voluminous topic, because if I had included it in this video, it would have been so much. So I'm gonna be dropping another video of the treatment of erectile dysfunction, which is impotence. So stay tuned while I drop it. So if you enjoyed this vlog, do you subscribe to my YouTube channel? Will I call it a vlog? It's not really a vlog. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, like, share, give this video a thumbs up, and then click on the notification bell so that whenever I upload the next video, you will be notified. Have a nice day. Bye.